Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll discuss bending of symmetric expressions of the roots. First of all, let us discuss what is a symmetric expression. Now, an expression f of xy is said to be symmetric if f of xy is equal to f of yx. Now let us discuss an example. Now here, the expression f of xy is equal to x squared plus 2x squared y plus 2y squared x plus y squared. And the expression f of yx is equal to y squared plus 2y squared x plus 2x squared y plus x squared. Now here, you can see that the expression f of xy, that is this expression, and the expression f of yx, that is this expression, are equal. Therefore, this is a symmetric expression. Now let us discuss the values of the symmetric expressions of the roots. Now we know that the standard form of the quadratic equation is ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0 and a, b, c are the constants. Now let p and q be the roots of this equation. And now, we will find out the value of the functions of p and q. And for this, we will proceed with the following steps. Now, the first step is find the sum of the roots, that is p plus q, and the product of the roots, that is pq, from the given equation. Then in the second step, express the function in terms of p plus q and pq. Then in the next step, substitute the values of p plus q and pq from the given equation, let it be equation number 1, and for finding out the values of the functions of p and q, we do not find the values of p and q separately. So for finding out the values of the functions of p and q, we will only follow these steps. Now let us discuss the following relations. First is p square plus q square. That is, if we have to find out p square plus q square, then it can be written as p plus q whole square minus 2pq. Now we have got the value of p plus q, that is the sum of the roots, from the given equation, and also pq, that is the product of the roots, from the given equation. And then substituting those values in this equation, we will get the value of p square plus q square. Our second relation is p minus q whole square. Now it can be written as p plus q whole square minus 4pq. Now again, we have expressed this relation in terms of p plus q and pq, and substituting the values of p plus q and pq here, we will obtain the value of p minus q whole square. Similarly, we will express the other relations also in terms of p plus q and pq. That is, the next relation is p square minus q square, which can be written as p plus q the whole into p minus q the whole, which is further equal to p plus q the whole into, now from the second relation we have got the value of p minus q whole square, so p minus q will be equal to square root of p plus q whole square minus 4pq. Now this relation is expressed in terms of p plus q and pq, so it can be solved. Now the next is p cube plus q cube, which is equal to p plus q the whole into p square minus pq plus q square the whole, which is further equal to p plus q the whole into p plus q whole square minus 3pq the whole, which is further equal to p plus q whole cube minus 3pq into p plus q the whole. Now again we have expressed pq plus q cube in terms of p plus q and pq. So by putting the values of the sum of the roots and product of the roots, we can find the value of pq plus qq. Now next, we have to find p cube minus qq. Now by the formula it can be written as p minus q the whole into p square plus pq plus q square the whole, which is further equal to p minus q the whole into p plus q whole square minus pq the whole, which is further equal to, now this is the value of p minus q whole square, so p minus q can be written as square root of p plus q whole square minus 4pq into p plus q whole square minus pq the whole. Now this relation is also expressed in terms of the sum and the product of the roots. Now let us discuss the next relation, which is p raised to power 4 plus q raised to power 4, which can be written as p square plus q square whole square minus 2p square q square, which can be further written as p plus q whole square minus 2pq. This whole square minus 2 into pq whole square. Again, it is expressed in terms of p plus q and pq. Now the next relation is p raised to power 4 minus q raised to power 4, which can be written as p square minus q square the whole into p square plus q square the whole, which is further equal to, now using the formula for this, it will be p plus q the whole into p minus q the whole into p square plus q square the whole, which is further equal to, now we have the value of p square plus q square, and also this is the value of p minus q whole square, and from this we can find the value of p minus q. So putting all these values here, this will be equal to p plus q the whole into, now p minus q is square square root of p plus q whole square minus 4pq into p plus q whole square minus 2pq the whole. Now this relation is also expressed in terms of p plus q and pq. Therefore, whenever we have to find out the value of the given relations, then first of all we will express the given relations in terms of p plus q, that is the sum of the roots, and pq, that is the product of the roots, and then by substituting the values of p plus q and pq, we can find out the value of the given relation. Now let us discuss one example. And in the example it is given a quadratic equation x square minus 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. And if a and b are the roots of the given quadratic equation, then find the value of the following symmetric expressions. First is a square plus b square, and second is a cube b plus ab cube. Now for finding out the value of these symmetric expressions, first of all we will find the sum and the product of the roots from the given quadratic equation. Now given the quadratic equation as x square minus 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. So here the sum of the roots, that is equal to a plus b, as a and b are the roots of this equation, is equal to minus the coefficient of x, that is minus 5, over the coefficient of x square, that is 1. So a plus b is equal to 5. Now the product of the roots, which is equal to AB, is equal to the absolute term, which is 4, over coefficient of x square, which is 1. So this is equal to 4. Now in the first part we have to find A square plus B square. Now by using this first result, we will express a square plus b square in terms of a plus b and ab. So this is equal to a plus b whole square minus 2ab. Now putting the values of a plus b and ab here, this is equal to 5 square minus 2 into 4, which is equal to 25 minus 8, which is equal to 17. Now we will start with the second part. Now again we will express a cube b plus ab cube in terms of a plus b and ab. For this, taking ab common, it will be ab into a square plus b square the whole, which is equal to, now ab is 4, into a square plus b square is 17, which is equal to 68. Therefore, this is how we can solve the values of the symmetric expressions of the roots. And now let us discuss formation of equations. Now let us suppose for the roots P and Q, we have to form an equation, that is a quadratic equation. Now as P and Q are the roots, that is x is equal to P and x is equal to q, are the roots. Therefore, x minus b is equal to 0 and x minus q is equal to 0, which implies x minus b the whole into x minus q the whole is equal to 0, or we can write it as x squared minus b plus q the whole into x plus b cube is equal to 0. Now, as p and q are the roots, therefore we have x is equal to p and x is equal to q are the roots of the equation. And from this, we have got x minus p is equal to 0 and x minus q is equal to 0. And for forming the equation, we will multiply x minus p and x minus q, and from this, we will get a quadratic equation in x. That is, x square minus, now p plus q is the sum of the roots, so x square minus sum of the roots, the whole into x plus p q is the product of the roots, is equal to 0. Now, if we have to find out an equation whose roots are given to us, then first of all we will find the sum of the roots and product of the roots, and then the required equation is x square minus sum of the roots the whole into x plus product of the roots is equal to 0. Now, let us discuss it with the help of an example. In this, we have to find the equation whose roots are 2 and 3. Now, for the solution, in the first step, we will find the sum and the product of the roots. So, the sum of the roots is 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5. And the product of the roots is 2 into 3, that is 6. Therefore, the required equation is x squared minus sum of the roots, the whole, that is 5 into x plus product of the roots, that is plus 6, is equal to 0. So this is the required equation whose roots are 2 and 3. Now next, let us learn how to find the condition when a relation between two roots is given. Now, before starting this, first of all, let us review that for a quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0, the sum of the roots is equal to minus b over a, that is minus coefficient of x over coefficient of x square. And product of the roots is equal to c over a, that is the absolute term over coefficient of x square. Now let us discuss the procedure to find the condition when the relation between two roots is given. Now the first step is, let us suppose one root is alpha. Then in the second step, write the other root by using the given condition, and by these steps, we will obtain two roots in terms of alpha. That is, the first root which we have supposed in step 1, and the second root which we will obtain by using the given condition. Now in the next step, write the sum and product of the roots using these two roots. And then in the last step, using the sum and the product of the roots from the given quadratic equation, eliminate alpha from the above expressions. Now let us discuss it with the help of an example. And in this, we have to find the condition that one root of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 may be 3 times the other. Now let us start with its solution. Now in the first step, let one root of the quadratic equation be alpha. Now according to the given question, the condition is given to us, that is, one root is 3 times the other root. So we have supposed one root as alpha. So the other root of the given quadratic equation will be equal to 3 alpha. Now for the given quadratic equation, sum of the roots will be equal to minus b over a. Now we have supposed one root is alpha and other root of the quadratic equation is 3 alpha. Therefore, sum of the roots, that is alpha plus 3 alpha, is equal to minus b over a, which implies 4 alpha is equal to minus b over a. Further, this implies alpha is equal to minus b over 4a. Now the product of the roots of the given quadratic equation is c over a. Now for the roots alpha and 3 alpha of the given quadratic equation, the product of the roots will be equal to alpha into 3 alpha, which is equal to c over a, which implies 3 alpha squared is equal to c over a. Now putting the value of alpha, this implies 3 into minus b over 4a whole square is equal to c over a, which further implies 3b squared over 16a squared is equal to c over a. That is, putting the value of alpha in this equation, we have eliminated alpha. And now, we will get the required condition. So this implies 3b squared is equal to 16ac, which is the required relation, or you can write which is the required condition when one root of the given quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 may be 3 times the other. So in this session you have learnt about the values of the symmetric expressions of the roots, formation of equations, and to find the condition when a relation between the two roots is given. So this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.